I'm Kathavachak and welcome to the realm of Katha. A few days ago, we brought to you the introduction story of Vikram and Betal. So today, in the same lead, we have brought a few stories from Betal Panchisi for you. So let's begin. The first story is about a young man named Suryamal. He was deeply in love with a woman and decided to marry her with her parents' consent. After the wedding, the procession started towards Suryamal's home. On the way, the procession was attacked by fierce dacoits who looted everyone and beheaded Suryamal and his friend. Stricken with grief, Suryamal's bride started praying to Goddess Durga and decided to commit suicide. Before she could do so, Goddess Durga answered her prayers and decided to bring both the men alive. Overjoyed with excitement, Suryamal's bride put Suryamal's head on his friend's body and friend's head on Suryamal's body. So now Betal asked King Vikram, "Oh dear King, so this was the story. Now tell me one thing. Who should the bride consider as her husband? The man who has Suryamal's head or the man who has Suryamal's body? Answer me now or your head will break up into 1,000 pieces." Reluctantly, King Vikram replied, "Dear Betal, our mind is the representative of our personalities. Now as the Suryamal's bride fell in love with his personality, the one with his head should be the one she should consider as her husband." Happy with King's reply, Betal said, "Dear King, you are absolutely correct. But now since you broke your vow and opened your mouth, I am now gone." And he flew back to the tree. With a heavy heart, King Vikram began his journey again. And Betal began another story. This story is about King Rupsen and his mighty bodyguard Veerwar. Veerwar used to protect the king from all the adversities, but also used to charge a hefty sum of 100 gram gold. One day, the goddess of wealth Lakshmi appeared before Veerwar and told him that there is a demon who lived in a cave near the village and he had decided to eat the king Rupsen to satisfy his hunger. Bound by his duty as king's bodyguard, Veerwar decided to sacrifice his life and hence entered the cave. After coming to know what Veerwar did to save his life, the king felt ashamed of not doing his duty to protect his masses and also decided to enter the cave to protect Veerwar. As soon as he reached inside, the goddess Lakshmi appeared in front of both of them and told them that how it was all her plan to test Veerwar's loyalty towards king as he was charging a huge amount. So now Betal asks King Vikram again, "Oh dear king, now tell me, whose sacrifice is greater? Is it King Rupsen or is it Veerwar? Tell me fast or your head will break into 1,000 pieces." So King Vikram answered, "Dear Betal, it was Veerwar's job to protect the king and he was only fulfilling his duty by entering the cave. But King Rupsen had no such obligation towards Veerwar and still put his life on line to protect him. Hence, King Rupsen's sacrifice is much greater than Veerwar's." Satisfied with his answer, Betal said to him, "Dear King, you are absolutely correct. But since you opened your mouth again, I am gone." Hence began the perilous journey of King Vikram again, and so did Betal's stories. This story is about King Yashodhan, who was a just and kind king. He was well respected across his kingdom and also by his courtiers. Once there was a businessman who was punished heavily by the king due to dealing in nostrils. In his kingdom, there lived a rich couple who wanted to marry their beautiful and able daughter off to the king. So they sent an invitation to the king, in return of which the king sent one of his courtiers to inspect that whether the girl is qualified enough to be his queen or not. The courtier conducted his investigation and thought positively about the girl. On his way back to the king, he was met by the same evil businessman who was punished by the king. The businessman convinced the courtier that the girl should not be the queen. She was really beautiful, and mesmerized by her beauty, the king would start neglecting his duties. This convinced the courtier, and so he returned to the king and lied to him about the girl. As a result of this, the king broke off the marriage with the girl. Now, after some time, the same rich man decided to marry off his girl to the king's commander-in-chief. He engages both of them and they fall in love with each other. One day, the king saw the girl and her beauty caught his eye. He immediately sent his ministers and commander to search for the girl and ask her hand for king's marriage. Now this put the commander-in-chief in dilemma, as his loyalty to the king was tested. Bound by his loyalty, the commander-in-chief broke off his marriage with the girl and sacrificed her for the king. On the day of the wedding, the particular courtier saw the girl and realized his mistake immediately. He went to the king and told him the whole truth. As the king was just, he arranged the marriage of commander-in-chief and that very girl, thus sacrificing her. Hence, Betal asked King Vikram, "O dear king, so now tell me, whose sacrifice was bigger? Was it King Yashodhan's or was it his commander's? Tell me fast or your head will explode into 1,000 pieces. King Vikram replied, "Dear Betal, love is the soul of life. It is the emotion that makes us who we are, the humans. King only sacrificed a girl whom he was infatuated with. But the commander sacrificed his true love for the sake of his loyalty towards the king. Thus, the commander's sacrifice was much greater." Betal smiled and said, "Oh dear king, you are absolutely correct as usual. But since you broke your vow and opened your mouth, I am gone." And so he flew back to the tree, and hence the journey began again. So these were some of the stories from Betal Pachisi. Until next time,